DJ Sheena on the ones and twos radio on the Advent today. Now, for those of you who are just tuning in your TVs, you missed out a whole lot over an hour. But anyway, it's never too late to join the fun because now, this particular moment, we'll be talking sports. Nicholas is joining me for this one. Good morning to you, Nicholas.
Ah, sigh of relief. January is over. Just give it a dub. It's over. Quick one. If someone met you for the very first time, they would think your reverend son, the guy who reads scriptures in the churches every Sunday, seeing you do what you do, especially on Fridays, the places you hang out to be like, hey. In Richard, I don't know how they would put that. But yeah, quick one. How have you been, though?
I've been great.
The week is done.
I've been reading scripture, bro. For myself.
That is why, Claire, I always tell Tina, there's always two faces, two sides of a person. There's that mask you wear for a particular occasion, another mask you wear for another occasion. Like the Nicholas who presents sports, and the Nicholas who would go out there and try to, wear down someone's daughter.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
That's true. I feel you, Blue. I feel you.
Sport this morning.
That's Nicholas. It's very dangerous. I don't think about that, Nicholas.
Hey! Tell you what, it's always two-sided. You go like, clear your face up, and then you take it off, and then you display what you have in mind. Okay. Always be honest about yourself.
You usually display what you have in mind? That comes a little bit
later. It comes from right here. This place here always misguides you. Yeah. It misleads you and you end up complaining. Now she changed me and broke so many things in there. But we get to proceed, by the way. At the end of the day, you've got to be happy.
Let's proceed with football, beginning it off with the UPL. Of course, we do have some fixtures lined up.
Yeah, we'll have two fixtures today.
Back in contention.
They're back in contention. They are, of course, in serious mode. Serious mode, I mean, they need to come out and get maximum points against the Kirinya side, who will be beginning life without their coach. That is, of course, Charles Ayoko, who walked away from his role. Yesterday, we had their club chairperson, that's Godfrey Osondo, unveiling officially Abe Bogere. Chikomeko was back, another stint for Abe Bogere at Kirinya. He knows what is at stake. Kirinya, not the best of my campaigns in the first round. They face a very, very solid side, and Vipers Sports Club, who will be in no mood to give anything away going into this game. A chance for Vipers to close in on log leaders in KCCFC. Currently, KCCFC leading by 6 points. A win today for the defending champions in Vipers would actually narrow that gap between them and KCCFC to 3 points. And I want to believe that Kirinya will have, Vipers have everything in the basket to actually get maximum points against Kirinya. That's, of course, Abe Bogere Chikomeko, who is their new coach, succeeding Charles Ayoko, who walked away from his role as head coach down at Kirinya. It will be very, very disappointing and very, it will be a huge blow if Vipers don't get anything out of the game against Kirinya. The other tie will be down in Arua, the Green Light Stadium, played at home against Indage University. Two sides that have struggled for form in the first round. The second stanza will be a chance for them to redeem themselves going into this particular affair down at the Green Light Stadium. Both sides in Indage University of coach Raymond Komakech and Pida Black Angels have gone 5 league games without a win. That shows what kind of state both club sides are in terms of performance. And I believe it will be quite interesting to see how both sides, come out and play again, face this game or approach this game in regards to match day 16. Those are the two fixtures line up this very Friday across the country in the Uganda Premier League.
We'll wait to see how that one unfolds, especially for our brothers down in Indeje University who have been struggling for form. Crossing over to the National Open Boxing Championship, we're getting to the finals.
This Sunday. I tell you what, it's going to be mind-blowing down there, especially this whole week where we had, of course, 4 days of resting. The National Open Boxing Championship does get to end this very Sunday. And for me, I think the highlight has been the turn-up on game days. The fact that we've seen so much talent, Joshua Tukamuheva, Kiza Katongo, all these youngsters coming out to showcase what they can do. So many sucker punches have been witnessed over the last week.
And
just to a point where you just have nothing to do but just throw as many jabs, as many uppercuts, as many punches as you can to your opposition. And the beauty about the National Open Championship is that it's a fast track program to pick out talent to, of course, have them represent the national team. And what Moses Mohanji, Shila's boss, by the way, has done over the last couple of months in office. He's five batters. There's been so many internal wars in there, but he has been the last man standing out for this game and fighting so much to have the game of boxing get back to the radar. And without a doubt, the fans have shown love for the sport, coming out in large numbers. Mm-hmm. And whoever wants to attend Sunday's final, you've got to come through early and get your seat, because it will be jam-packed down at the indoor center. But without a doubt, we'll be having some exciting boxing on Sunday. And of course, the winners from every category, the flyweight, the middleweight, the heavyweight, will be out there to represent Uganda in all of their own international and national engagements. But yeah, so far has been a very good, successful event. That's in the National Open Boxing Championship, where we've had so much young talent come out and showcase what they love doing best.
Venue, one more time.
Venue, Lugogo. Time should be 1 p.m. But like I said, if you want to get a seat for yourself, it's free. That's the beauty about
it.
It's free. So now, the fact that it's free, you probably have to be there early.
Okay, I'll think about that, coming to see some of those interesting boxes that will be thrown up. Now, looking into more news, of course, we want to get into some remarks coming in from the president of the Uganda Boxing Federation, Moses Muhanji, as far as this finale is concerned.
Very lighter note, 2019 has begun off on a very right foot for boxing, the National Open Boxing Championship. Could you quickly give us a detailed run as far as the championship is concerned?
Yeah, the championship has been going on since the 17th of this month, and we've been in almost for about a week now. We're going for the finals on the 3rd of Feb, and we have had very good participation for the boxers, the coaches. The National Council also have been tremendous, has been also involved in this whole stage. So I think we are going on well. The championship is the first event for this year, and it's been a success. You're going to see it at the end of the, by Sunday this coming week. So it's good for boxing. Boxing is back. Everyone is happy about it. Our partners are happy about it. Everyone is happy. The boxers have more hope than they used to have. So I think boxing is taking back its stage now.
Finally, before we wrap it up, you talk about success in the Open Championship. Can that success be pushed into the forthcoming boxing events?
Yeah, of course, this success is going to be turned into all our championships and the way we do our work, because this is just the beginning. So if we didn't have these other issues, the challenges, we'd be doing much more work for the Federation. So I think going forward, you're going to try to do either at this standard or something better than what we've done so far. So I think boxing is going to be extremely enterprising this whole year, and all the championships will be the standard. The boxers will be able to compete favorably. There will be extreme fairness on both sides. The jury system is on point. There are no more issues of match fixing or something like that. So I think we are good to go for boxing, yeah.
Quick one, Derek, it's been a blend of two things. The fact that we've had the boxing in the rings, and also the fact that there's been a campaign, an ongoing campaign since last year, on about HIV and AIDS. Every round, there's a Japan going around, Mwekume, use condoms before involving yourselves in that activity. Mm-hmm. And I think it's important. December, yes, is a day for World AIDS Day, but it's important for us to have that campaign go on for the rest of the year. That way, we have a safe environment, that way we'll have a safe Uganda, kick this deadly virus out of it. And that's something Muhanji and the entire boxing fraternity have done best in terms of trying to promote safe sex and try to also promote a free and HIV in Uganda. And this, I think, is very, very key in sports.
An interesting one, right? They'll wait see how that Sunday evening.
They do the same with Sheila at Gong Records. Do they have that moment where they do the counseling bit? Like, you know, no? It's just about
this.
You're grown people. Even grown people make mistakes, by the way. You might think that. You're old enough to make the right decisions, but you find yourself one night.
When was the last time you tested for
messes up your entire life.
Last month. Well done. Thank you. That's great. When was the last time you tested?
I'm a married dude.
At MTN Arena on Sunday.
Oh.
Yeah.
What? Before the game or after the game?
For the game.
Yeah.
The whole day it's free screening.
Okay.
Free screening or testing?
Yeah. It's the same thing, screening and testing.
Oh, you know, screening, I thought you just walk into a screen and then they...
You've taken that long.
No, I'm just saying.
But it's okay, let's come back and talk sports. Looking at the Uganda Football League, which is back in quotation, we do have Kabale University up against Nkumba.
Big games line up this very weekend. Of course, the University Football League new season is getting underway this very weekend, 3rd February. And a one game between Nkumba of Patrick Sebuliba up against Kabale University, a new entrant. That should be an exciting one, of course, for Nkumba, having a very ugly season last year in 2020. 2018, they'll be fasting to get nothing but a result against Kabale, who will be, of course, also eyeing for a place in the forthcoming University of Football League. Both sides bring something on table, and that's something we're about to unfold in Kabale as far as these two get to go. The other ties will have Mook up against KIU, and then a Gulu Derby or Northern, a North Derby between Muni University and Gulu University. The bit about this season in the University Football League is that the teams have actually been increased from 16 teams to 19 teams. That simply says that the league is growing, and we've seen so many players grow from the University Football League, moving on to venture elsewhere in the UPL. Yesterday, we had Ashaba Rahman, a champion last year with Chambogo University, earning himself a deal with the 16-time league champions in ACL. So for me, I think the UFL have done so much to promote and grow the game of football and give something back to the community. And we've seen this time and again, university students coming out to support the sport as well. Last year, it was about discipline. We saw Mook, who now return this very season, given a ban, and Mas, that is in Mbarara University, coming out, of course, also give a 2-year ban in regards to the campaign. They failed to honor 3 fixtures, and that did result to that suspension from the management in the University Football League. But yeah, that is, of course, the latest coming through from the UFL this very weekend. Kabale against Ankumba, Kea Yewe to Mook, and Muni against Gulu down in Gulu Municipality.
Welcome back from that short break and still watching us on today. This is DJ Shira from Gong DJs. And if you're watching us from wherever you're watching us from, but if you're probably watching us from DSTV, congratulations to you. You're about to get some information about what DSTV has to offer apart from Urban TV. That's, I mean, we're just cool like that. Shira, apart from Urban TV, what else would you like to watch on DSTV?
I actually have DSTV.
I know. I mean, what do you like to watch? I'm not trying to diss you.
I have DSTV.
I know. I mean, don't take it personally.
I watch CBS Reality. Mm. I like Nat Geo Wild, Telemundo, Z World, E Entertainment, obviously.
Backwear T-shirt. All right, this is Martin here. Martin, welcome to studios. Thank you for paying us a visit from DSTV. How is it going there? How is the new year?
DSTV, we are psyched. We are up in the game. And the new year has given us so much. We have the reintroduction of FA Cup. Mm-hmm. So all the things that you thought that you would miss, the FA Cup is back. So we have Man U through... I don't know about Arsenal, but
you just didn't do that. Are you a Man U fan?
Yes, definitely.
Yeah.
And we have more in sport, including the English Premier League, including the Champions League that we have to offer for you. And then brace yourselves, the UEFA Cup is soon coming back. Where Arsenal is real.
Man. So how are you offering these games? Are they probably in HD? Do you have some kind of slow-mo? What's the package for these games?
Those are actually so many questions in one.
Yeah, okay, let's start with the HD or
slow-mo, posing and everything. For every other decoder that we have, and let me remind the customers about the prices. We have the DSTV Zapa decoder, and that's what we run to call the normal decoder. The Zapa decoder, but actually it is in HD. We give you an HD picture. So that one is at 182,500. That includes installations. So if you have your money right now, you can pass by Kololo, our head office. You can pass by Buganda Road or even Garden City. 182,500. That includes installation and a month of compact at 115. So you are ready to see. The football game between Manchester City and Arsenal on Sunday.
And of course, you know where you fall.
Exactly. So, and then that we give you HD pictures on SuperSport 3, on SuperSport 7, 5, 6, all those are HD channels, including some of the movie channels like Premiere, all those are HD channels. We have over 50 HD channels.
When someone hears installation, probably, yeah. I mean, Lira chilling and I hear installation, what comes to mind is you give me my capac and the manual. What does installation actually mean?
Oh, okay. Installation basically is us mounting our dish onto a wall, or if you choose to give us a pole, something solid where we can put the dish, we can mount the dish. And then there are certain activities that are done on the decoder to upgrade it, to activate it, and all those things. That is installation. And that is done by our own technician, or we call them the eco technicians, that are really, really trained from our side. So you can't just buy and then you put yourself. Exactly. It's not a plug and play something. So,
and there's no extra cost for that.
It's 182, no extra cost. Unless you're moving 120 meters away, that may be the cable. But then we give you enough for your house.
So when you were installing DSTV, did you have someone do your installation or you did it
manually?
But that's the fact that, you know, DSTV is coming through to support us, the guys. Normally we spend the time in the bars, but, you know, I think if you have DSTV at home, you've done the installation, I think you can enjoy a match or two at home. Let's move on to
the posing.
Yeah, the posing.
The posing and the slow-mo. We have another decoder called the DSTV Explorer. And this, we call it the decoder on steroids, for lack of a better word. The decoder on steroids. What it does is magical things. You can pose a live picture. For example, now, if you're on Urban 288, you can choose to pose. And then you wait for me to do all the things, or you have something that you want to do in the kitchen, and then you find me where you posed from.
Hey.
Exactly.
So, if Tina banged the buffalo, which she did in the morning, I can pause it.
And then you rewind.
I rewind
and then you laugh again.
Okay,
so that's a DSTV Explorer for you. And it is at 280,000 without installation, at 350,000 with installation. So we give you with something that we call a satsia. A satsia is the LNB or the low noise breaker, that cut watch there. We give you with another one that can support the Explorer. So at 350,000 you can get yourself a wonderful that can pause. So clearly you can record a manual game
and then
watch the Arsenal game live.
Okay.
So you can record a game.
I can record a game as I'm watching another. Then watch it after. So I don't need to hop from back to back.
Exactly.
I have my
perfect. So that is it that we have from you for you, DSTV Zapper and DSTV Explorer, 182,500 Zapper, and 350
for the Explorer.
Let's
move on to the women, because the women usually man. When you're home. There's that fight between a guy and a chick. There's always, I want to watch soccer, but you've explained it. I can pause the soccer and later watch her soccer.
There's actually more that I'm going to give you as a solution to that after your question.
Okay, my question is, what do you have for the women?
Okay, and for the families at large. The women, they like their telemundos, and even if they have watched it before, they want to watch it again.
Yes.
So they want to watch from Telemundo, they go to ZeeWorld, then they go to Ever Plus, then they go to Viasat Life, and for you, they are watching with them. And you don't have to move.
Yeah.
So the solution to the men or the ladies, we have something that we call DSTV Now. DSTV, like DSTV, and Now, N-O-W. You can watch DSTV on the bigger screen, and then the man, you choose to use your tablet or tab, or you can just use your phone.
But we are tapping from the same.
But you're tapping from the same payment.
But you guys just want to kick everyone out of business.
not really. So we are telling you that if there is, in the event that there is a small fight, we can save you. We can save the day. So you know how
at
we...
At no extra cost.
At no extra cost. You know how we like watching our live games and everything, and then also the ladies don't want to miss the hassle because it's live and all those things. So you can watch... Go to Play Store or the App Store and you download DSTV Now, and then you follow the prompts, you do some registration. Make sure the telephone number that you registered with in the first place as you bought the DSTV is the one that you're using to register. Otherwise, you will find issues and all those things.
I love it.
So DSTV Now, we have so much to give to the customer.
Okay, 2019, February 14th is coming around the corner.
Buy your people some DSTV.
I mean, it's a good gift. It's a good gift. And you're like, you know what? You can watch your soaps, repeats, whatever. I'll watch it on my phone, my device. What else should we expect in 2019 as we wind up with this?
We have 2019 is a big gear, and Uganda Cranes. I cannot go out of here without speaking about the Uganda Cranes, and we shall give you the AFCON.
The AFCON.
Yeah. So much to expect. We have the live events in America. We have the live events in Nigeria. All those awards that our musicians and our film actors are meant to join, we shall show them on DSTV. We keep our promise. That we shall always do.
All right, thank you very much, Martin. I'll let you get back to work and business. But Sheila, on that note, now that you know that you can watch your Telemundos as I watch my game on my device, you can coexist together.
Yeah.
And you can also pause it in Azumbogo and play it again. I mean, DSTV, so much more. After the break, we are telling you...
Pardon?
What? You can watch Tina Zumbogo and play it. No, they have a remote. I don't need to do that, right?
Yes.
Let's take a short break. When we get back, we are looking at what places to visit or what events to have to, you know, attend this weekend after a short break.
Body language, brand new, coming in from Eddie Kenzo Msuza. The guy who has ambitions, dreams of starting up schools, but apparently, when he says you cannot take it.
Kamule Siga, Olina Lulenzi, Olawena. I go give you money and a jubilee son.
Wait, what? What is about the intro?
Uh-huh.
Which you're supposed to respect.
Uh-huh. No, I'm sorry. Yes.
Anyway, it's about that time. We'll let you know what is happening in different parts of Kampala. Where are you going to be? Where are you going to be spending that money? Now, Friday, today being Friday. Yes, the Friday night lights are back, baby. Season 6 down at Panamera.
Wait, why did he just switch his accent up when you said F?
Yes.
No, I'm sorry. Why did you switch your accent up when you said F and L?
That was a long time ago. They have been happening at Panamera. Please come and attend. Come and have a good time.
Willis is coming.
Come through this Friday.
He has wanted that opportune moment. Give it to him.
Yeah, today.
Yeah, today. Mm-hmm. Friday night. Hey, one lag. Friday night lights. Atembo, is it today?
Leave our plot.
No, there is... Do I
care? Oh, Lord, I love it.
And then, of course, tomorrow, the Caribbean Dance Hall Party will be going down at Cayenne, featuring our very own Jim Black alongside Nina Rouse. Hey, it's going to be a part of the cream you see. De la
cream. Why is cream with the...
You don't understand what was happening.
Cream, were your eyes okay in this particular moment?
Yes, that's what cream is for you.
Hey. What is drink?
Oh, I was drinking water.
I see you drinking water. We're all drinking water this weekend.
Yeah, let's have more of those events lined up, of course, on the screens right there. Now that's
Friday FNL. Night Lights, FNL.
Pana, so if you want to see Sheila,
we're going to be at Panamera. There's a silent discount.
Get in touch. Get in touch. Yeah.
It's going to be huge. Boxing.
And this is what I am showing up for, because Nicholas has told me it's going to be jump packed, it's going to be action packed. And you all know that one of my favorite sports to do is...
What is that?
I was boxing.
How?
I hear.
You box again for people to see.
What is this? Yo, you have to understand. Listen, you have to understand.
Listen.
Wow.
Listen. You're going to box.
Like this. Because one
leg in front with the thigh. Then the right. Yeah. Then
one
the right.
Fist in front.
It's supposed to be like
this. Fist is supposed to guard your face.
So can I show you if I know? Tell
him.
That's more like I need that. They can't really compare.
Boxing is going to be on Sunday at Lugogo. Come early. They're saying it's going to be jump packed according
free
to
free of charge, apparently. I didn't
very free.
Free of charge. Wow. Wow. Book market. It's also going to be huge.
I want to show you for that. I failed to pronounce that name.
Get in touch with us to find out where the Kampala book market is going to be.
Yes.
Of course, treating that. Urban TV Uganda. Then that is the Angalabi Short Film Festival as well.
Get in touch.
If you are
yes.
a film lover, get in touch with us, find out where it's going to be taking place.
For
you
love.
Can attend the Angalabi Film Festival. Hey, this is the London Kwagamaya. You must get in touch with us.
Chichusa
London Kwagamaya.
Nabagamba. Abantu ba ebonizi. Beba chatting zoku manyebi gambebi nene. These guys will have a show called The Itchulets. Yes, so London Quagmire is going to be definitely on with the Ebonies, of course, that's at their home at La Bonita. Other than that, I mean, in case you want weekend plot, you can always holler at us, tweet at us, Facebook at us. Is that even true?
And also, my Kabbalah is going to be happening this weekend. I mean, it happens every day, but this weekend.
The one with the blue light.
Yeah, the blue light and the curtain. The speaker.
Then there's that curtain there.
For 3K.
3K. Two, five. Chari kungule.
And if you buy two, you get one free.
Kungule.
Plus and when you drink and get high, they give you someone to take you home.
There's always someone.
This weekend, I'm going to be at Micah's.
Kabbalah.
Yeah, it's going to be lit, man. It's going to be lit.
I'm going to go do boxing and probably the book market because, I mean, I've noticed it's kind of hard and expensive to get a good book in this country.
You have leave. Don't come to my place. You're on leave. Sheila is going to sit in for you, not so.
Hey.
Why are you refusing?
He felt weak in the knee. Come back, honey. You need to come back.
Cooking oil.
I'm still on leave now.
I come here. Leave days is so komao.
But why?
Komao.
We have come to the end of the show. We'll see you guys on Monday. Be safe to not drink and drive. Please use a condom in case you're supposed to.
If necessary. Yeah,
if necessary. And if you can abstain, just do it.
Do it. Also works, you know.
Yeah.